Hey guys, what's up? It's Christine Sill, the High Level Queen, and today we are going to talk about how to set up high level with your sales teams. And this will work whether you have an appointment setter or several salespeople on your team. So let's get started. So for those of you guys who don't know, we actually have a free Facebook group called Marketing Agency Automation Secrets, where we give away hundreds of dollars in free trainings every single week to our members. So click the link below to go check that out. Now, to set up high level for a sales team, we are going to break this down into four easy steps today, okay? The first step is you're going to want to set up a phone system for your employees. Now, before you freak out, it's not that hard, okay? If you have a sales team or appointment setters that live outside the United States, they are going to need a US number to forward to when a lead calls them back. Super, super easy to do, okay? So you have three options that I've used, and you can go Google other options if you're not happy with those, but one is Vonage, two is Skype, and three is Zoom phone numbers, okay? I've actually used all of them, and they all work pretty well. You need to go set up that number so that you can do steps 2, 3, and 4, okay? So you can get a phone number from Skype, for example. It says $2.99 per month. All you have to do is follow this and sign up for that number, okay? So that's the first thing that you need to do. The second thing that you need to do is set up your numbers inside of High Level, okay? So we're gonna go over to phone numbers in the settings, and we're gonna click add number. Now you can choose your area code and pick any number in here, be good to go. Go ahead and click save. It's gonna add the number to your account. And I actually have a number here that we can test. Go into your pencil icon here, and you're gonna see a name, forward calls to. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna put, you know, team member number one, whatever their name is, right? The forward calls to, this is where you're gonna put their phone number, okay? So their Skype number or their Vonage number or their Zoom number, you're gonna put that in here, okay? And then in the whisper message, we always do call from location name. We are gonna put call from contact name in location name. So that's like if you have multiple locations. We like to do contact name because this actually says the name of the caller if that information's in the system, which is really, really cool. And then you want to make sure to turn on call recording. I just hit the space bar there. It depends on the laws in your state if you have to declare that the call is being recorded or not. So I'm just going to put that in there, and that's team member number one. So you're going to want to do this for each of your team members, okay? You have to have a different number for each team member, and you're gonna map the Skype or the Zoom number or whatever to the Twilio number. You're gonna forward it, right? So that's where this Skype number goes, okay? Now, the third thing that you're gonna wanna do is set up the high-level team accounts, okay? So we are going to click on Add Employee, and we are going to add our little employees in here. And now what we do here, if the person already has a high level account, we do like a plus one and it still goes to their email if they try to recover their password, but it is actually counted as a different email. So that's the little hack I can give you for that. Okay. Then this phone number, you are going to want to put their Skype phone number in here. Okay. So put their Skype number in here, and the password, you can make it whatever you want to make it, as long as it has capital and all that stuff. I think it's freaking out because I have a weird country on here. Okay. We'll do that later. Then you give them permission, whatever you want to give them here. I just keep it on user. And then this is actually really, really cool. You can set their Twilio number like this. So you're going to want to add that there. You're going to want to map it. And it says this is only required if the users need a dedicated number. Okay, so they do, right? Because they're calling, they're making cold calls, or they're doing appointments, or they're on your sales team. So if they miss a call, they're going to need to be able to call that back or receive that voicemail. And this is where you're going to want to set each team member's voicemail. You can actually do it for each user if you want to. You can do it at the account level or at the user level. So you can set like a custom voicemail for each person if you want. Okay, so do that here. You have to upload an MP3 or a WAV file. Okay, so I'm going to click on save. And then you've got your team account set up. So let's say we have three. So I'm just going to add another person. Okay. Now, what you would do, you have to, like I said, you have to have another number, okay? So you would have to set the second number, third number, and so on for each person. And you want to put their Skype number in right here, okay? Now, that brings us, guys, to the final step, step number four. What you want to do is set up your campaigns. So by that, what I mean is, let's say that we have a campaign and, you know, it's following up with leads, or it's adding to the appointment reminders, or whatever. How you do a round robin is you've got this users here in campaign configuration. You're going to click on add user, and then you're going to click the second person and click save, and it's actually gonna loop around between however many people that you put in here. Okay, so I've seen three people, I've seen eight people, however many people you want to put in there. Okay, now those are the four steps, and how this actually works together, it seems kind of like Inception when you think about it, but let's say that you have a VA who lives in the Philippines and they're doing appointment setting for you, okay? So they don't have a US number. You cannot forward a US number to a Philippines number in Twilio. It just doesn't work that way. So they have to get a Skype number, for example, in the US, install the Skype app on their phone, and then when they call out, they can use Gohighlevel to call out so that the calls are recorded, okay? So they use this, and they dial the number, and they click call, right? Then that way, make sure, you know, that you assign each number to the right person. But that way, the calls are going to be recorded in Gohighlevel. And when the leads call this number back, it's going to forward through Skype, which they're going to have the Skype app installed on their cell phone, ideally, or have Skype up on their computer, and they can answer it through there, but it's still going to be recorded and shown that the call came through Gohighlevel. Okay, so that's how everything's going to work together. And if you have a sales team, if you have multiple people, it's beautiful because it goes through and assigns these in the order that you put them on here, and it works really, really well. So hopefully that is helpful to you guys. Don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any important updates from me. And don't forget to go check out our free group in the description. And I'll see you guys next time.